Hi, you are watching VSDC channel, where we share editing hacks and detailed tutorials for aspiring video creators. Today we're going to show you three ways to create blurred edges, also known as vignette effect. Launch VSDC on your computer and let's get started. The first method is easy. Just add your footage to the scene and duplicate it. We'll tell you later what to do with the duplicate. In the meantime, turn its visibility on the timeline off and select the layer on the top. Head towards Video Effects, Transparency, Borders. In the Properties window, you want to start by tweaking the border size parameter because it instantly changes the look of the effect. See? You can leave it as is. You also want to make sure that you have a transparent mode on because it makes the edges of the video transparent. Plus, keep an eye on the position parameter. It can help you adjust the look of the effect for different frame compositions. And that's it for the first method. The second method is a little bit more complex, but it's also more versatile. Make a double click on the top layer on the timeline, then head to the top menu and select Ellipse. Create an ellipse, select the option to fill it with color without borders, and set black as the brush color. Next, move to the blending mode menu and select inverted mask. Okay, we've just created a mask for this layer. What's next? Let's blur its edges. Open Video Effects and select the Gaussian blur filter. Adjust the blur levels to the point when the effect looks the way you like and activate the Extend Boundaries option. It helps the blur effect expand outside the shape. All you need to do at this point is place the mask the way you need and adjust the blur levels accordingly. Now, if the black color for the background doesn't work for you, you can use any other color. Here's how. Go back to the main timeline tab, create a rectangle, the size of the scene, paint it white or any other color, and place it in the background. Now, remember there is an invisible duplicate on the timeline? We're going to finally use it for the effect. Go back to the main timeline tab, turn the layer's visibility on, click it and apply any of the following effects. Gaussian blur, distort, or raindrops. And by the way, if you need to go the extra mile and pin the mask to a moving object, you can do that with our motion tracker. Just make a right mouse click on the video and select Create Movement Map. Highlight the object or the area you want the mask to follow in the video and hit Start Analysis. Once finished, hit Apply. Now, just a couple more steps. Go back to the mask you created with the help of the rectangle. Then open the Add Object menu and select Movement, Movement Map. That's it! Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful and subscribe to get notified about the next one.